Hello students, today's class we'll see about flip-flop, introduction and SR flip-flop. We'll see the review of arithmetic building blocks, that is half order, full order and control inverter. Then we'll move to flip-flop, difference between flip-flop and latches, types of flip-flop, sequential logic and the flip-flop, SR flip-flop, SR flip-flop using NOR gate latch and NAND gate latch construction, clocked SR flip-flop, clock edge and flip-flop timing parameters. We'll see one by one. First one, what is flip-flop? A flip-flop is a memory element that is capable of storing one bit of information. It is also called as bistable multivibrator since it has two stable states, either 0 or 1. Flip-flops and latches are the fundamental building blocks of digital electronic systems used in computers, communications and many other types of systems. Let me repeat what is flip-flop. Flip-flop is a memory element that is capable of storing one bit of information, either 0 or 1. Both latches and flip-flops are circuit elements whose output depends not only on the current inputs but also on previous inputs and outputs. The main difference between latches and the flip-flop is latches does not have a clock signal, whereas the flip-flop always have a clock signal. This is the main difference between latches and the flip-flop. And I'll give you with circuit. This is SR latch. Here this S bar and R bar are the inputs and QQ dash are the output. Instead of this S bar and R bar, you can write S and R also. This is SR latch. So SR latch, we didn't use any clock. Then let us move to SR flip-flop. In SR flip-flop, we have constructed using NAND gate, but here the S and R are the inputs and QQ bar are the outputs. Here we have connected with clock. So that's the main difference between latch and the flip-flop. So in SR latch circuit, when we set S as active, the output Q would be high and Q dash will be low. This is irrespective of anything else. That is irrespective of anything else in the sense, so with any other combinations like 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, etc. So SR flip-flop, in SR flip-flop, the output is changed only when you give an active clock signal. Otherwise, even if S or R is active, the data will not be changed. So that means this SR flip-flop is active only with the function of this clock. So this is the main difference between latches and flip-flops. A flip-flop, on the other hand, is a synchronous and it is also known as gated flip-flop or clocked SR latch. The flip-flop is other name as gated flip-flop or clocked SR latch. So let us move to the types of flip-flop. There are four types of flip-flops: SR flip-flop, JK flip-flop, D flip-flop and T flip-flop. We'll see one by one. So first I'll discuss you about the sequential logic and the flip-flop. So it has the input and output and the combinational logic gates and also a memory element. So this is the sequential logic and flip-flop. Sequential logic consists of the combinational logic gates along with the input and output. And the memory elements are nothing but flip-flops, and the flip-flop is active only when we apply the clock. So this is about the sequential logic and the flip-flops. So next I am moving to SR flip-flop. So SR flip-flop is the simplest type of flip-flops. It stands for set and reset flip-flop. So S for set, R for reset flip-flop, that we can write it as RS flip-flop also, reset and set flip-flop. It is a clocked flip-flop. And this is the logic symbol for SR flip-flop. S and R are the inputs and this is a clock pulse. QQ bar are the outputs. So we can construct this SR flip-flop by using NOR latch and NAND latch. We'll see how to construct using NOR gate latch. See, this is R, S are the inputs and QQ bar are the output. Here SR flip-flop is constructed using two NOR gates. And this is the truth table. S, R are the input, Q is output. For 0, 0, Q naught, there is no change. 0, 1, 0. So that is reset, where the 1 appears as a condition. If one appear is here means that is for reset, and next condition 101 is appear for yes, so the condition is set, output is 1. When 11 is equal 11 is 0, that is invalid. So this is a truth table for NOR gate latch. So next we'll move to NAND gate latch. How to construct SR flip-flop using NAND gate latch? So this is NAND gate, two NAND gates and two inputs SR and Q bar are the outputs. See here 0 0, so the condition is invalid. Q dash is equal to 1, invalid. Then 0 1 1 1 is means reset. 10 means 0, it is for set condition. Then 11 is equal to Q naught, it is no change. So next, the truth table for the SR flip-flop is given with remarks. The same flip-flop only, the same truth table only with the remarks. See here SR and QN is a present state and QN plus 1 is the next state, and this is the condition. So let us see the conditions. 00 means QN, we don't know the condition, don't care condition. Then the output will be QN, and this is called hold state condition. That is S is equal to R is equal to 0, hold state. So whatever may be the state in the previous, that will be holded. Then 01 means it is reset, because 1 is appear in R, so it is a reset condition. So reset condition, S is equal to 0, R is equal to 1. Then S is equal to 1, R is equal to 0 means it is a set condition, because 1 is appearing in S. S means set, R means reset. So it's a set state condition. S is equal to 1, R is equal to 0. So next to 11 means it is a present state X and it is indeterminate. Indeterminate means invalid. We can't find the value when S is equal to R is equal to 1. So this gives the brief explanation about the SR flip-flop function. So next, clocked SR flip-flop. So the clocked SR flip-flop is constructed using two AND gate and two NOR gate. See RS, this is a clock pulse, and Q bar is the output. Okay, and the same clocked SR flip-flop is constructed using NAND gate. So let us see the truth table. C is a clock pulse. 0 means low. So S or no, don't care condition. We don't know what the state will be. So no change. Then we have to apply the clock pulse, high out clock pulse, 00 means there is no change, Q naught. Then S is equal to 0, 1, R is equal to 1, 0, so that means reset, because 1 appears in R, reset. Then 10 is 1, set, and 11 is equal to 11. When input is 11, then output will be Q is equal to Q dash or Q bar, that will be invalid. So this is the function of clocked SR flip-flops. So next I will move to clock edges. So this is positive edge transition. So this is a positive edge transition, and this is one state, and this is a negative edge transition, and this is a zero state. Again, this is a positive edge transition, and this is one state, that is high, and this is a negative edge transition. Okay, so I think it is clear. So let me explain you again. This is a clock edge. See here, this is one state, high state, and this is a high state, one. Right, and this is a low state, this is a lower state. So then when we apply the clock pulse, and this is a positive edges, these all are the positive edges, and these all are the negative edges. So the other name for positive edge transition is called rising edge, then negative edge transition called falling edge. Okay, so this is flip-flop timing. See, as I told you earlier slide, and this is a high state and this is a lower state, and this time is called TS is called set time, and TH is called hold time. So how long the state is getting holded is called hold time, and setup time is the initial time. So that I'll explain you again. And this diagram is for positive edge clock. So this is a SR flip-flop timings, and this 1, 2, 3 are the clock pulse, and this is for various input. When S is equal to 1, and 1 means high state, okay, 0 means that will be appear in 0, lower state. And similarly for R 0, then this is for high, then this is for lower state, and Q bar are the outputs. Okay, so next one, flip-flop timing parameters. So setup time, what is setup time? So that I mark it in the graph. I'll explain you the definition of set time. The time interval before the active transition of the clock signal, during which the data input D, J, K, whatever may be the flip-flop must be maintained. The time interval before the active transition of the clock signal during which the data input must be maintained. And this is about set time. So next one, hold time. Hold time is denoted as TH. The time interval after the active transition of the clock signal during which the data input must be maintained. How long the data input should be maintained is called hold time. So next one, propagation delay. Propagation delay is denoted as TPX. The amount of time it takes for the output of the first flip-flop to travel to the input of the second flip-flop is called propagation delay. Delay means it's getting late. So this is about set time, hold time and propagation delay. So that's all students, and I think you can understand well. So the next things we'll see in the next class. Thank you students.